Imagine your city is turned into a giant swimming pool, and not in a fun way. Floods are a powerful natural event that can happen anywhere in the world. Whether from intense rainfalls, overflowing rivers, melting snow, or even ocean storms pushing water onto the land, floods are a tricky force of nature we need to watch out for. It helps if we understand what causes floods, the different types of floods, and their impacts on the environment. So grab your goggles and let's make a quick splash into this rather unwelcome natural wonder. We've gathered some naturally wonderful things for you to explore on the Socratica Foundation website. Find more smart, fun videos and downloads, fact-filled games and activities that help you learn and remember. Find the link below. Have you ever accidentally left your sink running? Or maybe there was a leak in your home from a broken pipe? Well, floods are kind of like this, except instead of flooding your kitchen, they flood the entire city. A flood is when land that is normally dry gets covered with water. This can happen quickly or slowly depending on the type of flood. Flash floods are the fastest and most dangerous kinds of floods, happening suddenly because of lots of rainfall, often in just minutes or hours. They can sweep away everything in their path. River floods happen when rivers overflow their banks, which usually happens from lots of rain or melting snow upstream. Then there's coastal floods, which are caused by storm surges from strong weather, like hurricanes, which push seawater onto the shore. If you're curious about hurricanes, check out our video all about them, linked below. Lastly, urban floods happen in cities where the ground can't absorb all the rain that falls, often because of concrete and buildings blocking the way. So, those are the different kinds of floods, but what causes these in the first place? Floods can be triggered by natural events and human activities. It's true. Natural causes include heavy rainfall, which can quickly fill rivers and lakes above the amount of water they're usually able to hold. This leads to rivers and lakes overflowing and sending water all over that area. Snowmelt is another natural cause, where large amounts of melting snow, especially in the spring, add too much water to waterways at once. The combination of more rain and warmer weather melting ice makes flooding more common at this time. Another cause of floods are tsunamis. Tsunamis are giant ocean waves caused by underwater earthquakes or volcanic eruptions that can create devastating floods along the coast. On the human side of things, deforestation can be a factor in flooding. Deforestation is when people cut down too many trees, exposing bare land. They may have had what seemed like a good reason, like using the lumber to build schools and homes, or creating farmland, but there's a price to be paid. Deforestation removes trees that normally absorb rainwater, making floods more likely during heavy rains. Another thing that humans do that can lead to flooding is urbanization. Urbanization is when we transform natural areas into towns and cities. Modern cities use a lot of concrete and asphalt, surfaces that don't let water soak into the ground. The water has nowhere to go, so it floods the city. As you can see, both natural phenomena and human factors play a part in a lot of flooding situations. This is quite different from other acts of nature, like earthquakes, hurricanes, whirlpools, and volcanic eruptions. In our latest series, we're covering all these extraordinary natural wonders that we naturally wonder about. Want to take home a souvenir? Visit our website for smart, fun posters that are funny and fact-filled. Find the link below. The history of almost every civilization includes writing about a terrible flood. Their impact is so great, floods literally make history. One of the worst and most memorable floods was the 1931 China floods, which are considered among the deadliest natural disasters ever recorded. The Yangtze River flooded over 500 square miles. In the United States, the Great Mississippi Flood of 1927 was another big event, where about 27,000 square miles were flooded. Lastly, in 2005, Hurricane Katrina caused severe flooding in New Orleans that caused major damage to the city and surrounding wildlife. When a flood is happening, it can wash away plants, animals, and soil, which changes the natural habitats in the flooded areas. Unfortunately, floods have many more long-lasting effects on the local wildlife and human communities after the flooding is technically finished. They also damage homes, roads, and bridges, cutting off access to important services like healthcare and education. Long after the flood is over, the impact can still be felt in many ways, affecting the health and homes of both animals and people. So, can anything good come out of a flood? Yes, believe it or not. First of all, floods can help bring back our natural wetlands. Floodwaters carry nutrients that can build up the soil, which supports the growth of plants and provides a fertile habitat for wildlife. Also, in some agricultural areas, the silt and debris brought by floods can actually improve soil fertility, leading to better farmland once the flooding ends. So, yes, there are some positives that can come out of flooding, but it's still important to prepare for the negatives too. Preparing for a flood is very important for staying safe. Before a flood happens, make sure to create an emergency kit with essentials like water, food, flashlights, and a first aid kit. Stay informed by listening to weather updates and warnings on the radio or a weather app. It's also helpful to know the evacuation routes in your area and have a family emergency plan so everyone knows where to go and what to do if you need to leave quickly. While it may seem obvious, never walk or drive through floodwaters because they are much faster and more dangerous than they look. If you're caught inside during a flood, go to the highest level of the building, but avoid enclosed attics so you don't get trapped. Remember, the best protection during a flood is staying informed and being prepared. You must be wondering, is there anything else we can do? Well, lucky for us, the answer is yes. There are things on a larger level that can be done to help protect against floods. These include the work of governments, scientists, and engineers all coming together to protect our communities. Engineers use dams and levees to control water flow and stop rivers from overflowing. Dams hold back water, which can be gradually released to manage the water levels downstream, while levees, which are barriers built along rivers, help to contain and direct the flow of water. Also, meteorologists use radar and other tools to predict heavy rainfall, which often comes before flooding. As we learned today, floods are very powerful events that can impact the environment and human communities. They really are something to wonder about. Floods come in all shapes and sizes and can be caused by a whole bunch of things, from tsunamis to heavy rainfall to melting snow. They can be big, small, happen in a river, or because of an ocean. They can slowly build or come quick and seemingly out of nowhere. Most importantly, remember how being prepared can make a big difference in staying safe during a flood. Now it's time to watch another great video from Socratica Kids. You get to pick. And don't forget to check out our website with smart fun extras we made just for you, linked below. Did you know that these videos are made possible by our donors? The Socratica Foundation is committed to making free educational resources for kids. Donate today.